Back inside the Sanford Coyote Sports Center on a Sunday evening. Great to have you alongside today, and hopefully you're still on your way to the Sanford Coyote Sports Center, ready to pack this place and make it loud. It's TCU and South Dakota in the quarterfinals of the WNIT. Now over to the right side, driving inside, Kiana Ray had the ball stripped out of her hand. She got it back, had a wide open layup, and the lay-in is good. It's 3-0. A lot of contact here early on, kind of like Michigan State game, this game being physical, and a three-pointer for Kira Duffy. We're tied at 5. Left side, onto the wing to Kira Duffy. Duffy drives down to the baseline, spins it back out. Bradley wants the 3, got it! J.C. Bradley buries the 3. Dump pass inside, delivering house, spins up with a left hand and scores. We're tied at 12. Back up top of the point to Trimboli. Now left side onto the wing, Allison Arch. Drives baseline right by the offenders and she runs it up with her right hand. Jasmine Trimboli up the left side, fires over to the top of the point to Allison Arch. Arns, spin move in the lane on Ramirez up with her left hand, scores! Back-to-back buckets for Allison Arch. Lauren Hurd at the point, swings the ball right side, pass goes inside, knocked away. Great defense by Kate Leveringhouse. She jumped in front of Jordan Moore, knocked the basketball loose. Coyotes get the turnover. Allison Arns on the right wing. Arns drives right by the defenders, inside, got some contact, laying good for 2. And Bradley's into the front court, throws it up top. Allison Arns wants the 3, got it! Allison Arns buries the 3-pointer. Arns with 9 points already for USD. Left side Bradley fires the 3, got it! J.C. Bradley. Arns drives inside the lane, kicks it back out. Duffy wants a long 3, got it! Kira Duffy from nearly downtown Vermillion. McKeever bounce pass to a wide open Bradley, lays it off of the window and scores! J.C. Bradley cut inside, she has 10 points in the ballgame, and TCU wants a timeout. South Dakota 31, TCU 28, the Coyotes with their largest lead of the night. Fires a two-handed pass up top to Duffy, goes left side Bradley, down to the corner, Lamb for 3, yes! Chloe Lamb buries a 3, her first points of the ball game. 10 seconds in the quarter, McKeever drives by the defense, found a lane, layup good with 4 seconds to go in this first half. TCU will inbound, Ramirez fires the long shot, it's online and she got it, oh my goodness. And with that, the Coyotes lead is down to 3 as we go to the halftime break. Now with 10 to shoot to Allison Orr. Starts a pass into Bradley, free throw line, underhand toss out, Duffy wants the long 3, got it! Kira Duffy, big time, steps up, buries a 3. McKeever trying to sprint ahead up the right side. McKeever stops, pops the jumper for 2, it bounced off the iron, rebound Trimboli, offensive board USD. Left side, Bradley wants the 3 in the lead, got it! J.C. Bradley, and USD is back in front by 1, 5 to shoot. Allison Orange, shot fake, she'll drive in the lane, ran into traffic, up with a shot, scores! Allison Orange has 2 more points. Duffy had to save it on the baseline. TCU got the basketball. Ramirez inside, blocked away by Madison McKeever, and McKeever's fired up. Trying to get some momentum on the side of the home team. Pass up top, stolen away by Madison McKeever. McKeever's gonna go coast to coast in the lay-in, good for 2. Madison McKeever scores for 2. 15 seconds to shoot for USD. Frederick drives down to the baseline, up with a tough shot, rolls in, scores, and the Coyotes are within 3. South Dakota basketball, Bradley. 3-point answer, right wing, around and in. A 3-pointer for J.C. Bradley with 1:35 to play. Bounces inside the lane to Kate Leveringhouse. Leveringhouse trying to work her way into Moore, up with a tough shot, scores out the window. It's a 2-point game. Rebound, Taylor Frederick ran into contact, reverse land short, TCU basketball, and that's gonna do it. TCU wins it 79-71. Coyotes will wrap up a tremendous season, 29-7, in a season that saw South Dakota win the regular season title in the Summit League. Unfortunately, it ends here tonight before over 3,800 fans in the Sanford Coyote Sports Center.